Chill out. Stop dancing. Chill out. Stop dancing all crazy.
Ah, now we got your brother screaming outside.
We're letting one in, we're not letting one out.
Guys and gals, today is day numero uno to find out if I've been sleeping on 21 Pilots or not. Roll it. Welcome back to the channel, everybody. Channel's name is The Third Ernest. Y'all guys are the third family. I am Ernest Adiano, the third. And today, once again, we are rolling right along with the Patreon Request Subscriber Series. People who are subscribed to my immediate family tier on Patreon get one request a month. And the tier is filled up. I only allow 15. So I appreciate every single one of y'all 15 that has subscribed to that. I appreciate every single subscriber of Patreon, whether or not you're at the $5 tier or wherever the hell you're at, anywhere in between. Every dollar counts. Y'all guys want to check out what's going on Patreon and the exclusive perks that you get over there? I'm actually about to make a Discord, and I'm thinking about right now whether or not I'm going to make a Patreon exclusive one, whether I'm going to make one for YouTube, whether I'm going to make both and just differentiate between the two somehow. But if you want to check out what's going on over there right now, first link in the description. And today's request comes from someone who upgraded from their original tier to the immediate family tier that gets the Patreon request, and he did it just so he can get his request in, and I appreciate that, fam. And fam's name is Kelly Wilcox, aka Kelly 30STM, aka 30 Seconds to Mars. Kelly, I appreciate this request so much because a lot of people have been telling me to hop on 21 Pilots, but I'm hyped for this right now because a lot of NF, a lot of Nate fans, a lot of people in general like 21 Pilots, and I had just been sleeping on them because if anybody knows anything about me, once something is way too hyped up or there's way too much like buzz around it, I automatically am done in the hype. Like, I'm someone who doesn't like a lot of hype because most shit does not live up to that expectation. So when I heard 21 Pilots and I saw their face on the radio, when I saw it all over the radio in San Antonio, Texas, where I'm from, I was like, I don't know if I'm really gonna be able to fuck with them because the radio in San Antonio, Texas is straight doo-doo, son. Like most garbage radio stations of all time. So if they're playing 21 Pilots on the repeat, how could I possibly like them? But y'all guys hyped them up. So I'm pretty excited to see whether or not they live up to the expectations that y'all have set in my head, or was I correct to be done in the hype? But there's only one way to find out. Now, before we get started, I will say I just clicked on the video to load it up. The video's got 231 million views. Where have I been? This song better be 231 million worthy, fam. That's a fuckload of views. But let's go. This kid right here is about to spit some bars. Is that what y'all are trying to tell me this whole time? I mean, I'm not judging him by how he looks, because obviously we know that it don't matter how you look, don't matter what you wear, it doesn't matter your skin tone or what type of tattoos or whatever you have. If you can spit, you can spit. But can he spit with the X factor? That's what I want to know. Because there's people who can spit, but they just don't have that X factor. The beat is fire though, that boom, 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 boom. And then the way the drums came in with that hi-hat cymbal. They just say it's your lane, boy. Bruh, this is fire. The production on his voice, the way they make it sound like it's in that ambient hall room, and then his like high-pitched tone as he's singing or like sing rapping, whatever he's doing. Whew. Okay, it's pretty solid so far. They said stay in your lane, boy. That's a dope ass bar right out the gate. Cause everybody says stay in your lane. You don't look like you can rap. You don't know if you're gonna be rock. What are you? You're rock, you're pop. Pick your lane and stay in it. Don't be trying to fucking switch lanes all over the place. And then that little dance move that he did, like he's doing a Pee Wee Herman move one time. But will they be alive tomorrow? They think this thing is a highway. If it was our way, we'd have a tempo change every other time change. Cause our minds change on what we think is good. I wasn't raised in the hood, but I know a thing or two about pain and darkness. If it wasn't for this music, I don't know how I would have fought this. Bruh. He's fucking going in. I wasn't raised in the hood, but I know a thing or two about pain and darkness. Everybody's got their own version of Pain and Darkness. You don't gotta be strapped. You don't gotta be out on the street selling drugs all the time. Pain and Darkness comes in many forms, famo. I don't know what the fuck these dudes are doing in the white with like the old school like nuclear mask type vibe, like it's Fallout 4. I don't know why we're like in a concert vibe right now with the drummer, but then we're like in the middle of like this fucking forest type vibe, like it's Cabin in the Woods. I wasn't raised in the hood, but I know a thing or two about pain. If it wasn't for this music, I don't know how I would have fought this. Regardless, all these songs I'm hearing are so heartless. Don't trust a perfect person and don't trust a song that's flawless. Honest, there's a few songs on this record that feel common. I'm in constant confrontation with what I want and what is popping in the industry. He said he don't even like some of the songs on his own album because he's in constant confrontation, constantly battling what's popping on the music charts and what he really wants to write because he knows his fucking style is not going to get out there. He knows his message isn't going to get out there unless he writes those pop hits. And I guarantee you a lot of people who are at that level of fame and success, especially music artists, they struggle with that shit all the time. Because you got all these different heads talking to you. You got these A&Rs, you got the record label that want to make their money. They want to put you on the radio. They want you to go on tours. But normally whenever you do what they say, your talent and your potency and your lyrics and your music capability gets watered down to appease the masses. Fire. He said, don't trust a perfect person and don't trust a song that's flawless. Because a song that's flawless is probably made up. That's not real life. Real life has flaws. Real life isn't perfect. And I'm in constant confrontation with what I want and what is popping in the industry. It seems to me that singles on the radio are currency. My creativity's on the free when I'm playing shows. They say, saying you're lame, boy, but we go where we want to. Bro, these little like ghost dudes in the back with these little dance moves, I'm fucking with it. That little fucking stutter step that they did right there, right here. We go where we want to. They think this thing is a highway. The hook is fire as fuck too. Sing songy, easy to memorize. I bet you in concert when they play this song, dope. Guaranteed, because everybody out there is singing that shit. But this song is most definitely living up to the hype so far. I would jam this like tomorrow. I'm probably gonna download this song as soon as we're done. And I also like in this dark scene where they're walking on that path, I like that he like looks like he has like this dazed drunk just staring at a 100-yard stare into the abyss, into the distance. Almost like as if he's being controlled. Controlled by the music industry. Like he's rapping, he's singing, he's doing what he's got to do, but it's like he's got no emotion on his face. He's just doing it because he knows he has to. Baby, I'm alive tomorrow. I'm sorry if that question I asked last scared you a bit like a hazmat in a gas mask. If you ask Zach, he's my brother, he likes when I rap fast. But was not ready for the spit. Hold up one time. Baby, I'm alive tomorrow. I'm sorry if that question I asked last scared you a bit like a hazmat in a gas mask. Zach, he's my brother, he likes when I rap fast. But that's a bar right there because these motherfuckers back here, they always look scary. Not just in this video, but it's like an unsettling presence whenever you see someone in like this gas mask type thing. And you know, like in every scary movie or in every movie about nuclear war or whatever back in the 40s or whatever, this is like not a good sight to see. But anyway. Scared you a bit like a hazmat in a gas mask. If you ask Zach, he's my brother, he likes when I rap fast. But let's backtrack, back to this. Who would you live and die for on that list? But the problem is, there's another list that exists. And no one really wants to think about this. Forget sanity, forget salary, forget vanity, my morality. If you get in between someone I live with me, you're gonna feel the heat of my cavalry. All these songs I'm hearing are so heartless. Don't trust a perfect person and don't trust a song that's flawless. Is it saying you're lame, boy? I feel like because those lyrics right there didn't make any sense to me, that I'm missing something from another song or another album somewhere. It's like when I listened to The Search for the first time and a lot of shit that I was watching on the video, I was like, what the fuck's going on? So if I'm missing something, if I need to listen to another song or another portion of this album or a previous album before in order to understand what's going on right there, let me know in the comments. Because he's talking about a list. And then there's another list, and I don't know what the list he's talking about is. But yo, that little dance that they did right there, like, it's like all scary and like all moody and shit, but then all of a sudden they just bust out in this little three-piece choreography. This song and this vibe is all over the place, and I fuck with it because, like, there is no lane for the song where he's saying stay in your lane. It's like eerie, like the vibe of the song, the vibe of the music video, and then we got like concert footage all of a sudden, and then we got these eerie dudes in the back, and then they start dancing with him all of a sudden, and it's like the video has no lane. So even the video itself is portraying exactly what the song is saying. Perfect person and don't trust a song that's flawless. Is it saying you're lame, boy? Lame, boy. But we go where we want to. fire. Damn, that wave. I was wondering what he was writing on them, because it was obviously illegible as fuck. But it said fame and success, I think. But this is dope-ass concert footage right here. This wave is dope. And he's wearing the shirt that he's wearing in the fucking park or wherever they are. He said, tempted by control, controlled by temptation. That's fire. Maybe I'll have tomorrow. Boy, that distorted ass voice, what would they be like tomorrow? And then this whole other different vibe and tempo, it's like not even the same song now. Now it's like EDM, but not really EDM. Like fast-paced dubstep EDM. There's a genre for that, but I forgot what it's called. But the song is all over the place, and I fucking love it. Bruh, 100% guaranteed their concerts are fucking sick. Like, just that energy right there that I got. It's so hard to, like, put energy from a live concert into a video because you're not actually there. But that was dope. The whole song is fire. The whole concept of the song is fire. I'm assuming fame and success are in those things because they're toxic traits of the game. Speaking of the game, if you haven't seen the Lupe Fiasco video, boop. Right there, if I remember to annotate, because sometimes I don't, so sue me. And the fact that fame and success are personified in this video and they have these hazmat suits on, I'm assuming, presumably meaning that they're not good for you or they're negative side effects that come with doing what you love. But then fame and success are vibing too. They're not just out there like creepy as fuck. The drummer was going off like a motherfucker too. Son, I'm hyped. That shit was so dope. I can't even front on it. I can't back away. I can't front. I can't move side to side. Cha-cha, real smooth. But really, Kelly, fam, I appreciate that request because that right there opened my eyes. And I want to say that I'm pretty confident, like 100% confident, that that second verse has some shit from like other songs the way NF does that I need to listen to in order to understand what he's talking about with these lists. So if someone wants to leave me something like in the comments saying the songs that are like important to that part so I can check them out. So way if I know I'm like delusional or not. But Kelly, for your first request, that one was fire, fam. One for one, I gotta say. The rest of the fam, the rest of the potential fam that's watching this that's not subscribed, I hope y'all guys appreciate this video. I hope y'all guys appreciate the breakdown and my reaction and all of that bullshit because I'm genuinely hyped. That was the first time I ever heard any 21 Pilots. And not just heard, but like actually listened. Because there's a difference between hearing and listening. You hear your air conditioner and your refrigerator compressor turn on and off every day. But now that I pointed it out, you're actually listening for it. But yo, if you're watching this video right now and you like what you see and you're not subscribed, please consider subscribing and hitting the notification bell. We're trying to get this family to grow. We just passed 25,000 subscribers most recently. So if you want to join along on that train, channel is still relatively young for the most part. If this channel was stock in a publicly traded company, you would want to buy in right now because the potential for future dividends and the potential to see the gain is there. But yo, I really appreciate everybody that's watching this. Kelly, once again, I appreciate the request. All my Patreon people, I really appreciate all the monetary support y'all guys give me over there. As you know, as I always say on every video, y'all guys are the ones that keep the channel afloat, that allow me to pay my bills, that allows the channel to continue. Otherwise, I'd have to be going and taking more videography gigs. I'd have to be going and taking more photography gigs, and that takes away from my time on YouTube. So the fact that y'all guys are willing to support that and kind of supplement the fact that I don't have to take those gigs allows me to make more videos for y'all guys, allows the channel to grow, allows me to interact with y'all more so than I ever would. So I appreciate everybody that subscribed. Y'all's time is valuable and I don't want to waste it, so I try to put out the most entertaining videos that I know how to. I got love for every single one of y'all, and like I say at the end of my videos every single time, go out there in the world, love and care for one another, love and care for each other, and I'll see y'all guys on the next video. Peace.